our world is facing unprecedented climate challenges. Many of the challenges we face can be directly linked to human activity. Nature offers multiple solutions to the various problems facing humanity today. But time is running out, and we need to act now. This is why the United Nations Environment Programme and Partners for Resilience have developed models for increasing community resilience in different landscapes to address different types of hazards in 5 countries: Uganda, India, Indonesia, Haiti, and Ethiopia. Each country project has focused on 3 elements: ecosystem restoration and protection, disaster risk reduction, and climate-smart livelihoods. This is what we refer to as ecosystem-based disaster risk reduction, or Eco-DRR. Each project has taken on a slightly different shape and form in adapting the 3 elements to better fit their local context and needs. In Uganda, the project focused on micro-catchment models to address flooding and drought. In Haiti, the project enabled communities and humanitarian actors to address landslides and flooding. In Indonesia, the project focused on peatland management for fire management through a biorights approach. In India, the project focused on wetlands and water management for reducing flooding and drought. In Ethiopia, the project focused on water and rangeland management for addressing drought and food insecurity. Although the projects each took a different approach, they achieved common targets: benefiting women and men to become more resilient, restoring or protecting ecosystems, and training community-based organizations so that they can continue to implement Eco-DRR with communities. And the benefits have considerably outweighed the project costs. These figures include direct benefits such as carbon sequestration, avoided losses to property and livelihoods, economic and health benefits from honey production, shea nut production, fruit trees, and much more. Our project has strived to highlight the importance of strengthening partnerships and engagement across various sectors, such as civil society, educational institutions, local and national government, in direct collaboration with the local beneficiary communities. This is fundamental for creating an enabling environment of continued advocacy and resilience. In doing so, communities, including the most vulnerable, have greater capacity to identify and address the rising risk of disasters exacerbated by environmental degradation and climate change. We all have a role to play when it comes to protecting our health, our people, and our planet. We must act now in protecting nature, as nature is our greatest ally. Protecting nature means protecting ourselves and our future generations. Yadowa, Yaturiwa, Omegua, Nahamegua. Ilova, you can any right to tell, put ya by the Arabinometi, wood, Tonguyen, right? Where would you go? Arabinometi, wood, Tonguyen, right?